Greetings, people of the internet. This is Scott with Circworks, and this is 100 Days of Making Comics, in which I set aside at least 30 minutes a day in my busy schedule to make time to make comics. Today is day 4. It is also the 4th of July. So if you are in America, happy Independence Day. I got my Captain America t-shirt, so I am ready to roll. But enough about that. Let's get down to talking about comics. So what am I thinking about today? What have I worked on today? Well, last night I went to an exhibit at the Phoenix Art Museum. It's the Hollywood Costume Exhibit. And I think it's just about to run out. I think it'll go through this weekend and then it's probably going to move on to another city. So if you are in Phoenix and you want to check that out within the next 2 days, I highly recommend it, or just check and see if it's coming to wherever you are. But yeah, it was really cool. I got to get up and close and personal with some of the costumes that I've come to know and love from movies and not so much television. I guess it was just movies now that I think about it. But you know, they had Darth Vader's costume. They had the dude's robe from Big Lebowski, Austin Powers, they had Superman, Christopher Reeve's Superman, Spider-Man's costume, stuff from Blade Runner, the Addams Family, let me think what else. And then they had like, you know, period stuff, like they had stuff from Shakespeare in Love and Chicago, and you, it's one thing to see it on screen, but when you see it in person, it really adds a whole nother dimension to it. And so I really gained kind of an appreciation for that. One other thing that I thought was really cool, so I'm walking up there, next to the Darth Vader is this kind of this long robe, and it's kind of spacey looking, but it's, I'm looking at it, is that Ming the Merciless from Flash Gordon? But it didn't look like the 80s one, so I go, that must be from like the old Buster Krabs serials, but it was weird because, you know, if you've seen the 80s one, it's all flashy and red, and this was kind of more drab gray, but it had that feel to it. And then I'm like, oh well, yeah, that was in black and white, so maybe they don't have to worry so much about color. So that was just an interesting kind of segue there. But anyway, so again, it was really cool to see all these costumes, and it got me thinking about how costumes and fashion and things like that inform the characters in our story. Most of the stories I've done that I'm doing or I've done in the past take place in another time period. I don't know if they would be called period pieces because it's not. I always wonder what a period piece is. And from my understanding, I guess the fashion of the time has to have drastically changed or something like that. I don't know. That was the description I heard. But anyway, so mine take place in the 80s, the 70s, things like that. Usually times that I was around for, at least briefly, as far as, well, 70s, I guess I was pretty young, but I was, you know, I was around. So I've had different series take place in those time periods. So when you're designing characters, nowadays with the internet, it's so easy to just go online. You search for, search for whatever images you want. One thing that I've found that while that's great and you can get a lot of that, especially if you delve real deep on the internet, but usually, like with my comic Young and the Dead, it takes place in the 80s as following a group of kids and everything. And if you search like 80s fashion or something like that online, you're going to get it's kind of more what people come to remember, or it's more the more outrageous stuff. Like you're going to get the Flock of Seagulls haircut or the Miami Vice, you know, jackets with the tees and the big hair and all that. And of course there was a lot of that out there, but not necessarily, that's not necessarily what everyone wore, you know, every day. And I wanted this to be, mine follows a group of kids. They're not so fashion conscious. They're probably just wearing what their parents bought them and things like that. So I was trying to, when I first started designing these costumes, I'm just getting all this, you know, stuff that looks, it's going to make your characters look like they stepped out of an MTV music video. And that's not really what I wanted. So what I did, and I will show you another thing you can look at. And don't forget, there's still libraries and things like that. There's physical things you can pick up and check out. But let's see what's behind me, behind this closet door. Oh, I know you thought it was gonna be the bat pole. Sorry to disappoint, but it just a bookshelf. So I got a lot of references here. But one thing that really helped me out, because I'm old, I just went out and I lived through the 80s. And I pulled out my old, this is my junior high school yearbook. So I was probably a little bit older than the characters in my story, but the fashion's pretty much the same. So this will give you kind of a more realistic, and I imagine you can probably look through like 80s yearbook photos or things like that online too. That might work as well. But I don't want to point anyone out in particular, but I mean, you can really see like some of the hairstyles and a lot of, you know, striped kind of Garanimal type shirts and things like that. But this, I think this gives you a little better, you know, at least to help me in coming up with some of the costume designs for my character. You know, it's just funny to look back at. I mean, this, some of these styles are crazy. And look at this idiot right here. This guy playing air guitar. Oh, wait, that's me. So, oh, this just, hold on. So I'll come back to this in just a second. This just fell out. This is a school newspaper. If you want to know how long I've been creating comics, this is circa 1985. So this is April 30th, 1986. This is a comic book that I created back then. The 10th Earth. First shocking double-size issue, years in the making, a Scott Cirklin comic book. You love that old English style type face right there? Isn't that cool? So yeah, I've been doing this since I was a kid, so that's why I love comic books so much. But anyway, so these things, these yearbook photos and things like that, and of course, if you're younger and you're doing a story that took place back then, you might not have access to these, obviously, but I don't know, you might be able to find these at like a thrift store or something, I don't know, or similar things. Or like I said, you could probably look up yearbook photos and things like that. But those type of things are a little more accurate as far as the time period. And like if any of you guys have go-to resource materials that really work for you outside of just what's kind of readily available on the internet, please let me know, because I'm always looking for new ways to do that. So let me kind of show you an example of some of the finished stuff here in my comic. Again, it's in the 80s, so you can see here this little scene. You've got my little Shogun warrior. There's a Star Wars Death Star. These are all things I had as a kid. And like, if you look at the shirt, it's kind of, again, that stripey Granimal type style shirt. I've got another character here who is kind of more... She's kind of following the whole Cyndi Lauper, Madonna type stuff. She's more of a teenager, so she's a little more fashion conscious. So I've got kind of, this is Kelly, and she's got, you know, she's kind of trying to mimic that kind of Madonna look. That's some of the ways that I just inform my character using costumes and things like that. Let me go back and talk a little bit about an old comic book that I developed. I never finished it. I'm planning to kind of go back to it. But this one takes place in the 70s, so styles are going to be a little bit different. This is a comic book I was working on called Retrofits, and it's kind of my take on a superhero story. It's about these five kids. They're all kind of orphans, but they come together and they form this bubblegum pop group, and then they kind of just vanish off the face of the earth, and they come back, or they vanish off the face of the earth, and then they appear like 20, 30 years later with these superpowers. They have no idea where they've been or what, so it's kind of like a character out of time story where here they are in this world that they don't really understand, and they've got superpowers on top of that. So that's kind of the idea behind that. But so you can kind of see, here's some shots from this. Style's a little bit different than what I've got in my other book. This is kind of a two-page spread here. So you've got kind of the guy with the funk outfit. You've got, you know, he's kind of like the either Commodores or something like that, or Jackson 5 style. This guy, you've got the Charlie's Angels shirt going on. she's kind of maybe like a remnant from the hippie era and all that stuff. So yeah, so those are some different characters there. And then I introduce a villain here, and back when I was doing these, here, let me pull out my file here. I've got, this is just filled with like, this is not before the internet, but I used to, for whatever reason, I used to print stuff out. I don't know if there's a date on this. I think it's back in the 90s sometime. So I used to just print things off the internet. Now I do a lot of stuff. I'll save things in Pinterest or whatever, and it's a lot easier to manage. But so I've got all these different 70s fashions and things like that. You know, you've got your one character I kind of modeled after Sean Cassidy. So he's, you know, I've got some photos in there. But then I had a villain character, and see if I can find that. Oh yeah, so I've got a villain character called Ricky Stratosphere, and he's pretty much modeled after David Bowie, Ziggy Stardust. So I've got some things in there, and I'll kind of show you how he turned out. So that's Ricky Stratosphere. But anyway, so that's just a little bit of information of how I costume some of my characters, and I'll do a lot of. Let's see if I have some sketches here. Maybe not. Thought I did. Oh, well, here, since it's 4th of July, this is one of the costumes I created. This is back in the bicentennial era, so there was a lot of American flags and things like that. I've got all kinds of references and stuff I'll pull from every now and then when I can't find what I'm looking for on the internet. I've got this Rolling Stones, the 70s. I pulled a lot of stuff from there. Don't be afraid to look at your traditional media for inspiration and reference. That's probably about it for today. Again, it's the 4th of July, so I'm gonna go blow some stuff up. I'll see you later.